talking to some details. You're telling me about the least relevant.
You brought this as an evidence to your support, to your case.
Relevant?
And then you cannot substantiate with a single piece of
what you say?
Documentary evidence from any records. So in the whole of the New Testament, do you find anyone calling Jesus Emmanuel after the supposed proclamation? Okay. I may be mistaken that there is. Do you know of any text?
Okay. Again. What are you saying?
Did you hear what he's saying?
Yes.
Failed prophecy.
Yes.
No one called him Emmanuel.
What are you saying? I call him Emmanuel because I think of him. Listen.
Did they call him Emmanuel during his lifetime?
Listen.
Where's your evidence?
Because you're talking about such a triviality that actually I feel like I'm wasting time with you now.
Oh, yes, of course.
Instead of looking about the message of Christ.
Yeah, what was the
message? Instead of looking at the message of Christ, you're telling me whether the Greeks called him Jesus, or whether they call him Joshua, or whether they call him Jesus, or whether they call him anything else.
Yeah. So they are
talking about trivialities,
good.
Man.
Leave the trivialities. So
why
even Christ
starting
message,
with trivialities?
Christ messages, there are three gods in heaven, worship them all together.
No, he didn't say that. You're distorting, you see.
Let me ask
now you're distorting.
Okay. No, I'm asking. No. So according to Christ's message, how many gods are there? You said three.
I just told you. So my words,
you said three.
It's the words of scriptures. Where there are three gods, there are
three gods. Right. Now tell me.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Is each, are all of these three gods all-knowing?
I am not in divine state to let you know what they know. What they know? Do you? Are you in divine state to know it?
My question is this: Father and Son, and who's the third God?
It's the Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit.
Yes.
Does the Son know everything?
The Son knows what he was given by his Father.
That's not my question.
Yes.
I repeat my question to you again: Does the Son know everything? The answer is yes or no.
Everything that is has been created.
That's not my question
Christ,
either.
Therefore, yes, he knows everything.
That's not my
creation.
My question
yes.
is totally
Christ,
unrestricted.
That's right.
I don't have like, oh, does the Son know everything?
So if I look, let's say if I know the words of God to be that God has created through Christ everything, and through Christ, in fact, everything came to existence. Yes, that I have to say. That for me, that means that God, that Christ knows everything. That's correct.
Okay. According to Christ, who knows the hour when it's going to come?
Again, you see, that's a very good question. If you knew this scripture, you'll find out when Jesus spoke these words in the one of the first lines before he started his teachings and his ministry, he would say to his mother, "You shall not tell me what to do because my time has not come yet." That shows you that Christ was doing the will of his Father. He was not working out of his own will. He was acting out of the will of God Most High. So when he's saying to me about he knew about the time, he knew that his time had to be in agreement with the Holy Spirit and with the God Most High. So what that gives you an answer?
So you didn't understand my question. According to Christ, who from the three gods knows the hour?
I just told you. You didn't listen.
Let me give you options. The Father alone knows. The Son knows alone. The Holy Spirit knows alone. So maybe one of those three knows only the hour, or all of them know, or two of them know, any two, like the Holy Spirit and the Son only know the hour and the Father doesn't know, or the Father and the Son knows and the Holy Spirit doesn't know, and likewise.
Okay,
wait, I'm giving you options now.
Those options are relevant to anything.
Wait.
What are you saying?
According to Christ in the scripture, the message that he has left for you, who knows the hour?
Again.
Is it?
I told you.
No, use the word Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit and nothing
why
else.
Don't you use intelligence?
No,
I told you.
Okay, let me
that
tell
Jesus,
you. Let me tell you.
Jesus, I just told you the words. Since he was aware.
Excuse me.
That when he said.
According to Christ.
Time, when he said these words. Yes, listen. Since he was fully conscious of timing, when he said, "My time has not yet come," which shows you that he's fully aware of time and when he's supposed to start his work while on earth. So to me, that already shows you something. That means something, his proper relationship.
He knows or he doesn't know?
Yes, that he knows his time there was not there yet.
Good. So, yes. So about the time of the hour, hear my question. Yeah. Does he know? The answer is, he knows, he doesn't know.
No.
Which
again,
one? Which one?
Misguided because,
wait,
you,
wait,
because
wait,
you're
wait.
Teaching of wait. A man in front of you. It's eternal being. God is eternal being.
May
therefore,
I suggest like this?
Hold on.
Would you agree that God is an eternal being? Okay. Now let
yes
me.
Yes or no?
Let me.
Yes or no?
Let me.
Is God?
Let
is
me
God,
come
is
back
God,
to the question.
Is God eternal being?
Let me come back to the question.
Is God eternal being?
Relax.
Is God eternal being?
Do you know my name?
I don't need to know your name.
Okay. Either you know my name or you don't. Okay. There is no third option. Okay. Now, likewise...
Again, you manipulate.
Excuse me.
I hear your manipulation.
Likewise,
I just told you.
Likewise, the God who you call Jesus, either he knows the hour or he doesn't. Which one is it? Does he know or does he not know?
Jesus, in the spirit of Christ,
simple.
Was an eternal being. So for him, the time has nothing to do how you perceive time.
Does he know or does he not know?
Again. No, you just don't comprehend what I'm saying. Hear me out.
Just give him
relax.
Jesus, Christ being an eternal being.
It's very hard to crack often.
It's an eternal being. Means it's above time.
Yeah.
Above time. God is above time. It's an eternal being. Holy Spirit is an eternal being. They're above time.
Sure.
So to them, concept of time is the same thing like for you checkerboard or chessboard. Okay. There it is. However, because human being has a freedom, and also because Christ came here not of his own will, but came because of God's will. Therefore, he looked at the time from an entirely different perspective, how you comprehending time. Because what you think a time is, has nothing to do with how eternal being looks at the time. It's a totally different thing.
So the answer was simple.
There you go again.
Either he knows or he doesn't.
Again.
So can you now? Can
you?
Hang on. Can you now summarize in these two options? Does he know or does he not know? Which one?
Again. Doesn't matter how many times you go around, I'm trying to explain, eternal beings have an entirely different concept of what time is. If you're mortal
you're
an immortal state, right?
Listen,
if you're in a mortal state, for you time goes by. Right?
Listen, being an eternal being in your concept.
Yes, not my concept. Muslims also believe that God is eternal being, right?
I'm trying to make it easier for you.
No, for me, actually make it difficult for yourself. Go on.
So, does the God who you call the Son know when the world's going to come to an end? The answer is yes or no. So which one?
Yes,
no. Whoa. Come to the end. What do you mean by that? Again, because when you speak come to the end, you mean end of what? Meaning that one is going to be a finish line.
You know what?
You made it. Finish line.
What
finish
do you
line?
Make of that statement when Christ said, of that day, of that hour, no one knows. Not even the angels in heaven. Not even the Son. But only the Father. Now, in that statement, tell me who doesn't know the hour first.
Okay.
No one.
Okay.
No angels. And no Son as well.
Again.
Wait, I've not finished. It says, but only someone, but only the Father.
Yes.
If Jesus says only the Father knows, can you know as well?
No, I cannot.
Can he know as well?
Who he?
The Son.
The Son.
Jesus, you mean?
Son.
Yeah. The Jesus, I already told you, Jesus has his task on earth in time. In time, Jesus has been placed upon with the task which is given by his Father, which I told you is in Isaiah 53. And then Isaiah 53 also says that kings wouldn't recognize Messiah. No one would know among them that the Christ would come. Why don't you read the Isaiah 53 to see what I'm talking about? It was the God's secret fled away from mankind when the Messiah would come. So what he's saying to me is completely, again, you're talking some abstract though, because every time I'm trying to explain to you that the Christ's work is not finished. So Christ, when he came for mankind, he didn't come, let's say, only for Christian people.
Am I talking about bananas?
Huh?
Am I talking about bananas?
Yes. No offense.
That's why you're answering like that, yeah? Because you hear in your mind that I'm talking about bananas.
Yes, because you're giving me answers with bananas,
right?
You go to trivialities.
Right. Okay.
Who called Jesus Emmanuel?
Listen.
And stop.
I have a drink in my pocket. A friend of mine gave. Right. If I told you, no one knows what drink it is. Is it water? Is it Coke? Is it orange juice? Only my brother Muhammad over there. From my statement, do you think?
He said he has to go. He's got night shift.
He knows as well? He knows as well? Or only Muhammad knows?
But again, what are you talking about, man?
This is about language. Whether we're speaking the same language or not.
Clearly we don't, because you're talking about trivialities. You're talking about trivialities.
Trivialities.
You continue to talk about trivialities.
So when Jesus, my friend, when Jesus says only the Father knows, it means Tom knows as well, Dick knows as well, so does Harry. Is that right?
No, it's not.
So what does only Father knows means?
It means.
Again, only Father knows or someone else knows?
It means that until the work of Christ is fulfilled, that in mankind, those who will come in the future, will be redeemed from whatever keeps them into mortal state.
Someone say fruitcake. Carry on.
Okay. Okay. And you're happy with that, aren't you?
No.
Okay.
We have enough bananas, enough fruitcakes.
Okay.
Let's have a meaningful discussion.
What I'm saying to you, if the work of Christ will be complete, then perhaps we can find out whether Jesus knew about the concept of time as you're speaking. As we speak right now, the force of Christ is within every human being who has any sense of redemption
and
yearning for freedom.
Thank you. Now, so when Christ says, Father is the only true God, you think, no. That's not true.
Who said that?
Wait. Christ said that. Father is the only true God.
And I told you also,
Wait. So, when Christ says Father is the only true God, actually it doesn't mean that. There can be other gods as well.
No,
when
Christ didn't say other gods. He didn't say other gods.
When somebody says, you are the only true God, when you make an exclusiveness by the word only, I do understand English is not your language, first
Neither
language.
Neither is yours.
Yeah, no, I do understand English is not your first language.
Neither is
yours. You're having difficulty with the...
So do
look,
you.
Look, if somebody says only, you understand it doesn't mean only, it means something else as well, isn't it? Yeah, clearly.
Go on.
Clearly.
Yeah.
So you don't understand what only means. Clearly, in this conversation.
Yeah. Obviously, I clearly
so
do.
If we say...
Again,
he's the only begotten son.
So when John 3:16 says, the Father sent his only begotten son, does only mean only here, or he's got other begotten sons?
Again, if you're referring, for example, to book of Genesis.
Sorry, John 3:16 says, God so loved the world, that's the verse, right? He sent his only begotten son.
Yes.
Now, when he says only begotten son, do you mean there are other begotten sons of God, or he's the only one?
He's the only son of God.
Good. So now you understand what only means. Thank you for that.
Go on.
Bravo. And, well done. Now, bravo to you. You've now realized what only means. So when Jesus says, you are the only true God, can there be any other gods apart from him?
Again, what are you speaking as God? When you speak...
Okay.
When you speak,
thank you. Thank you.
Double standards. Bye bye.
Finish.
Carlos.
It's called double standards. Literally double standards. You can't even
Islam will free you from the slavery of mind.
Islam.